Did you know that congruence theorems are just simple ways to show that two triangles have the same size and the same shape? By the end of this video, you'll understand everything you need to know about all five congruence theorems. Before we dive into the five ways two triangles can be congruent, we need to make sure we know what congruence means. I've placed two figures here that look like peanuts to show you what congruence is. Two figures are congruent if they have the same size and the same shape. It doesn't matter what position they're in, or if they're turned, or if they're rotated. In a similar way, we say that two triangles are congruent if their corresponding sides are equal in length and if their corresponding angles are equal in measure. Let me clarify what corresponding means. When two triangles have corresponding sides, those two sides are in the same relative position. The same holds true for angles. For example, if we have triangle ABC and triangle DEF, we would say that sides A and B are corresponding to sides D and E. Let's now dive into the five ways two triangles can be congruent. Congruence theorems are geometric principles that provide conditions for two triangles to be congruent. In other words, all they do is provide the conditions for all the corresponding sides and angles to be equal. Our first congruence theorem is called side-side-side. Three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another triangle. Our sides in blue are equal. Our sides in orange are equal, and our sides in red are equal. Our theorem tells us that if we know all three sides are equal, we also can know that all three angles are going to be equal. Our second theorem is called side angle side. Two sides in the included angle of one triangle are equal to two sides in the included angle of another triangle. Our sides in blue are equal, our sides in orange are equal, and the angles between these two sides are equal. Our next theorem is called angle-side-angle. Two angles in the included side of one triangle are equal to two angles in the included side of another triangle. Our angles in red are equal, our angles in orange are equal, and the sides between these two angles are equal. Our fourth theorem is called angle-angle-side. Two angles in a non-included side of one triangle is equal to two angles in a not-included side of another triangle. Our angles in red are equal, our angles in orange are equal, and a side not between these angles, called the not included side, are equal. Theorems 1 through 4 were for oblique triangles or triangles that are not right triangles. Our last theorem is for a right triangle and is called hypotenuse-leg. The hypotenuse and leg of one triangle is equal to the hypotenuse and leg of another triangle. The two hypotenuses are equal, and then one pair of legs are equal. Let's summarize all of this. If the conditions in any of these five theorems are met, then we'll know that the triangles are congruent. All their sides will be equal, and all their angles will be equal. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.